welcome to Ndimkhulu's Kitchen with Marco TV. Ndimkhulu's Kitchen is all about education. Every day there's something new to learn in the culinary world, and I thought that I should be imparting my knowledge on some of you that are interested in certain aspects of the hospitality industry. So today I'm going to be starting with fine dining, and I'm going to be giving you a few tips on wine service. So if you're interested in this topic and you would like to learn more about a wine, about the world of wine, this video is just for you. Please do enjoy. If you have not subscribed to my YouTube channel already, please do, and click on notifications, boop, so that you can be notified whenever I drop a new video. Enjoy. Some of us at home know wine to be that little extra kick at a party or any occasion where it's gonna give us a nice vibe the entire evening and possibly wake up with no hangover the next morning. The world has plenty different types of wines, some names we can't even pronounce, but the three categories of wines are red wine, white wine, and sparkling wine. Let us take a look at some of the equipment that is associated with wine and wine service. I'm going to start with the wine glasses. There are three standard wine glasses. Depending on the manufacturers, many different types of restaurants, to be fancy, will serve you certain types of wine glasses that you may have never seen before. But the three traditional type of wine glasses are as follows. Red wine glass, white wine glass, and something called a champagne glass or a flute glass. Now let's look at these two, the red and the white glass. If you can see clearly, the red wine glass is much more fatty than the white wine glass. Why is this so? Is it an intended purpose? Is it just a mistake? Well, it's intended. Red wine is known to be very strong in its aroma, and it needs a wider surface to breathe in order for it to have its best quality come out for a guest when drinking. Therefore, the red wine glass is much more fatter than the white wine glass. Okay, we have something called a carafe. Basically, a carafe is a vessel in which you pour wine into and serve to a guest, allowing a guest the option of pouring how much of wine he or she would like in their glass at any given time. Then we have something called a decanter. A decanter is very similar to a carafe. The only difference is that a decanter has a lid, which allows you to store wine for a longer period of time. You also have other vessels for serving wine, which are fancy, this being one of it, which can also be regarded as a decanter. This is known as a wine or ice bucket rather. For example, white wine that needs to be chilled, it goes in here in a bucket of ice. We do not open wine bottles with our teeth or our hands. We use specialized tools, which are known as a corkscrew, which is the most easiest way, I think. And then you have something known as your waiter's friend. This is an essential tool that a waiter should have on him or her at all times. That's a basic gist of equipment that you need. There are various types of equipment that you'll come across in a bar area, in a fine dining area, but that's the standard type of equipment that is associated with wine and wine service. Have you ever heard people say that champagne can only be called champagne in France and nowhere else? Well, that is the truth. Champagne, or traditional champagne, is made in the Champagne region of France using seven different types of grapes. Any other type of champagne that is made out of the Champagne region of France is regarded as sparkling wine. That's the difference. Wine is an expensive item of beverage, and it should not come to a guest table in any type of way other than respectfully. A waiter who serves wine is referred to as a sommelier. This waiter needs to have thorough knowledge of wines and the background of wines in order to assist any guest with any type of questions they may have regarding the wine. So, how do you present the wine to a guest at the table? A waiter or sommelier should have something called a service cloth in his left hand at all times. The bottle of wine should go into the same hand on top of the service cloth with the label facing the host. This enables the host to read the label correctly and ensure that the correct wine was brought to his table. As I said, wine must be treated with a lot of respect as it is associated with elegance and luxury, and people generally spend a whole lot of money on the most fine and expensive wines. When you're opening the bottle, the waiter or sommelier needs to ensure that he or she is handling the bottle with grace and respect. So, the sommelier should never be interfering or touching the bottle and putting his or her fingerprints all over it unnecessarily. The bottle should be held in the hand of the sommelier at a 45 degree angle, never to be left on the table while opening the bottle. How do we open the wine bottle? With our teeth, maybe at home when we are a bit tipsy, but we use either a corkscrew or, as I said, an essential tool that the waiter should always have on him or her, which is called your waiter's friend. Emphasis on the respect that the sommelier takes on the bottle of wine and pouring the wine is very vital, even in this segment. A wine bottle should never ever touch the glass of the guest who you're pouring the wine for. The bottle should not be left on the table at any time. So, what happens with the glass of wine that needs to be poured? How am I going to hold this bottle? Expensive bottles especially have some type of assistance for a sommelier where they have a little hole at the bottom, if you can see this here. What happens is that you put your thumb in there like this and you hold the bottle like such and you are able to pour a glass of wine. So, let's try. I'm doing red wine, so I'm using my red wine glass. Okay, so the sommelier first pours for the host of the table. Is he going to pour a lot? Is he going to pour the whole glass? Is he going to just use his own discretion? No. When the host needs to taste the wine, you just pour a little. So we're holding our thumb into the bottle, pouring the wine just a little bit like that. I did spill. Okay, we're going to try that again. Okay, here's my red wine glass. So the sommelier will just pour a little in the glass for the host to get a taste of it. When you are about to stop pouring, you lift your wine bottle up and you twist it a bit so as not to spill any wine. That's going to be very embarrassing, which is what I did a few seconds ago. Anyway, we're learning, right? Okay, so why did we pour just a little? Because the host of the table needs to taste it to make sure that he is satisfied with the wine that you are serving him. Have you seen on TV when people do wine tasting, especially with red wine, they will swish the wine around the glass, sniff it, then take a small sip to just get a hint of what that wine is all about. This swishing action activates the quality of the red wine, bringing out its aroma to the best level, which will enhance the wine and obviously make the guest happy. Once the host is satisfied with the taste of the wine, he will then give you a go-ahead to pour wine for the rest of his guests. Now, how would you know who the host of the table is? Generally, the host of the table is the person that is sitting at the end of the table, or the person who has being paid for the bill, or the person who has made a reservation for that table. For example, if you're serving a couple at a table, you always pour for the female first, which is common courtesy. If you're pouring for a group of people and you're not sure, you just pour for the host first, and then in a clockwise direction, you pour for all the other guests. So coming back to the amount of how much do we pour? Are you using your own discretion? Do you judge someone on the way they dress to say, okay, this one needs a bit more wine, that one doesn't even drink wine, Holy Ghost? No, the rule is that with white wine or even rosé, you pour 2/3 of the glass. With red wine, you pour just half the glass. What does a sommelier do after he's done pouring? Remember that the host has paid for the entire bottle. You cannot take the bottle back into the kitchen, hello. So, white wine is served chilled, as I said before. So therefore, white wine will go into an ice bucket, which will be placed either at the end of the table or on an ice bucket stand, away from the space of the guest. Red wine is generally served at room temperature, and therefore the bottle can just be left on the table. Question. How many glasses of wine do you think comes in one bottle? 5 glasses in total. Let's say the guest or the host has ordered just one bottle and there's 6 guests. What do you do? Because they're not speaking of a second bottle being ordered. You will just shorten the amount of wine that you pour for all your guests. And there you have it. After a while, the sommelier needs to ensure that he keeps checking up on the table to ensure that guests are okay. Do they need refills? Do they need a clearing of the table? Or are they willing to order another bottle? And basically, that's your FYI in a short version of wine and wine service. I hope that you did enjoy the segment. I will be doing more educational videos, so do stay tuned. As I said, please do subscribe to my YouTube channel. Click on notifications, poop, so that you can be notified whenever I drop a new video. Thank you guys, and I hope I've taught you something today that you did not know yesterday. Bye-bye.